Hi everybody, I'm Rebecca Keppel. I'm super excited to be here on ThermoWeb's YouTube channel. I have four different cards to share with you today. They're all using the brand new ThermoWeb Pixie Spray, Stencil Pal, and Metallics Gels. And these three things work really, really well together, but they can be used with other things as well. Okay, so first I wanted to show you the Pixie Spray. It's a light tack repositionable adhesive. It's perfect for stencils. The next thing I want to show you is the Stencil Pal. The Stencil Pal is way better than using a palette knife or a credit card or anything like that to lay mixed medias over stencils. And I'm going to show you specifically how to do that with the Metallics gel. So I'm starting with a Heffy Doodle stencil. This is called Zap Attack. And I'm going to lightly spray the back of the stencil with the Pixie Dust. And you can see I'm doing that right over a glass mat. I get a little bit on the mat, which then holds down my cardstock to the mat. And then I place the stencil down on top of the cardstock, and the spray on the back of the stencil holds the stencil to the cardstock. So everything is staying in place. This is the Deco Foil Metallics Gel in Glazed Pewter. I'm going to place a bunch of it, good sized globs, on the straight end of the Stencil Pal. The curved end is for your hand and it makes it easy to position your hand around the Stencil Pal. I'm going to place it at about a 45 degree angle and I'm just going to start working it across the stencil. Now this stencil has openings and diagonals to all corners, so you kind of have to go in a bunch of different directions. But the Stencil Pal makes it really easy because you're covering a huge amount of the stencil with that tool, and it's super flexible so you can get into the little grooves with those Metallics gels. So I'm gonna stop the speeding up of the video so I can show you how easy it is to remove it, even with that repositionable adhesive on the back of the cardstock and the stencil. It just peels right up. And look at the impression that I got from the stencil. It's absolutely perfect because it hasn't shifted at all during the application of the Metallics gel. I'm gonna do it again, a little faster this time. I'm using the Raise the Roof stencil. So again, I got a little bit of that Pixie Dust on the back of the cardstock, which keeps it in place on the glass mat, and then on the back of the stencil, which keeps it in place on the cardstock. And then I'm using the Stencil Pal to put the Pure Gold Metallics gel on this Raise the Roof, and then I just peel it right off. And the thing is, I don't show the cleanup, but it's really easy to clean up the Metallics gel off a glass mat. It just wipes up with a baby wipe, and the Stencil Pal and anything else there, your stencil, can be cleaned with some warm soapy water. Just don't let the Metallics dry. This one, I used the Ring of Rosies stencil and the White Pearl. This time I am using the Candy Store stencil by Heffy Doodle, and I'm going to be using the Black Ice on that gray cardstock. So once they were all dry, this is all four of the backgrounds together, it was time to turn them into cards, and I wanted to show you how quick it was using these Metallics gels backgrounds to turn them into cards. So I have a circular design stamp set as well as a sentiment from a Simon Says stamp set. And the sentiment says, "Have I told you lately that you're amazing?" And I'm going to be stamping this on some Gina K Designs cardstock with some black ink. And I thought between the black and the pewter metallics, the Zap Attack and this color of cardstock, it would make a nice masculine card. So I'm cutting the sentiment out with a ThermoWeb Gina K Designs stitched circle, and I'm just holding it in place with my purple tape. And then I'm gonna use some of the black foam tape to pop this circle up right in the center of that Zap Attack. And that's it, this card is done. I think that that background design looks great for a masculine card. For a more feminine card, I thought I would adhere this candy store stripe down to a 4.25 by 5.5 inch pink piece of cardstock. I've also stamped and colored and die cut a magnolia flower and leaf and happy birthday greeting from a waffle flower crafts stamp set. I'm gonna pop the flower and the leaf up again with some of that black foam squares from ThermoWeb Gina K Designs. since it's going on a darker background, I thought it looked fine with the black foam. And that completes that one. They just have so much shine and even a little bit of dimension because of the metallics gel that you don't really need to do a lot. So for this one, I'm going to stamp another little pattern circle right in the middle of that stenciled metallics white pearl design. I've cut out another circle with those stitched circles from ThermoWeb and Gina K, and I'm going to stamp my sentiment on the edge there and then just ink up the edge of that just so that everything kind of flows together and goes along really, really well. And I like these colors together, so I thought the ink colors and then the inking around the edge and then the cardstock kind of brings the whole piece together. And then I'm just going to mount this because I cut it down to about 4 by 5.5. So I'm mounting that on 4.25 by 5.5 inch piece of white cardstock. And then I'm going to pop up that circle once again. This time I'm going to use the white foam squares from ThermoWeb Gina K Designs. I'm just going to move it over. I wanted it kind of like off center from that center circle there. I decided to add some Tonic Studios Nouveau Crystal Drops in Calming Aqua because it seemed like I had a monochromatic look going there between the aqua and the white, but you don't need to add those if you don't want to. There's so much impact with the background. For the last card, I used the Raise the Roof stencil, the Pure Gold Metallics, and I cut it down to about 5 by 5, mounting it on some black cardstock that's 5.25 by 5.25, and I have a stitched circle die cut of black cardstock with my sentiment heat embossed in gold, and I cut off the bottom so that it could be flat to the bottom of the card. And now I'm using some Ultrabond, which is ThermoWeb's really strong liquid adhesive, to adhere some gold sequins. Again, that background is so impactful that you don't need to do this. I thought it was just a fun look, kind of went along with the gold and sun theme there. So that's 4 different ways to create 4 different backgrounds using 4 different colors of metallics. We also have metallics in a champagne color and aged copper, so I'm sure you'll see me using those in a video in the future. But I just wanted to share how easy it is to create these backgrounds using the Pixie Dust and the Stencil Pal, and how much fun they are to work with and turn into cards. If you're interested in any of these products, they'll all be linked down below for you. I want to thank you so much for stopping by today. Have a wonderful day.